Hi everyone, my name is Kendrick and welcome to Travel and Live Free. In this video, we're gonna cover my country number 67, 68, and 69 to visit every single country in the world. And those countries are Montenegro, Albania, and Macedonia. I forgot to mention that during my time to go through those countries, I also got a chance to transit through Kosovo, which is not an official UN recognized country, but pretty much it is gonna be recognized as a country at some point in the future, in my opinion. After arriving from Serbia, I got a chance to spend overnight in a city called Podgorica, which is the capital city of Montenegro. I would say this city has some of the best fish I've ever eaten. I fondly remember going to a restaurant and ordering fish, and it was so delicious. I would so love to go back there and eat fish again. It was just so good. The people in Podgorica were stoic looking, and most of the time no one really expressed any emotion on their face. They're pretty kind of like stone face. I didn't spend that much time in Podgorica other than eating a lot of seafood and also eating some kebabs. Before long, I took a long bus ride going from Podgorica through Albania, Kosovo, and finally ending up in Skopje in Macedonia. The first part of my trip was pretty smooth sailing, and before long we arrived in a restaurant stop in Albania. From there, I got a chance to order some food and eat those food while hanging out with other travelers from Turkey and Mexico. Little did I know that the food that I ordered from this little restaurant would give me one of the worst food poisoning I've ever had in my life. By the time we arrived in Kosovo, I was feeling quite bad. I wasn't sure why my stomach was hurting and I was feeling chills. But before long, we got back on the bus and we were now on our way to Macedonia. However, while we were driving towards Macedonia, I had the worst feeling ever. I really needed to use a toilet. And unfortunately for me, the washroom in the bus does not work, and therefore there's no washroom for me to go to. After feeling the worst chills I've ever felt in my life, I begged the bus driver to please find me a washroom because I needed to go. So after a while, the bus driver managed to find me a gas station. I quickly gunned into the washroom. The washroom had no toilet paper. Oh my God, that is a horrific experience. And I did my business there, which is a little bit too much information, but I thought I'd illustrate stories of what happened. And man, it was just one of those really bad travel experiences that I would never wish on anybody. Before long, I got back on the bus and I was still feeling sick. So by the time I arrived in Macedonia, I quickly hurried my way to my hostel, got checked in, and again had to use the toilet again because I was feeling sick. And the hostel was pretty good. The owner was a little bit of a control freak. There was like rules all over the wall, and this guy was just super paranoid about something bad is gonna happen. Although it was really clean, which is plus side of staying in this hostel. The next day, I was too sick to go look around, so I asked the owner if I could just hang around the hostel because I was feeling so sick from being food poisoned. At first, he said I cannot stay in the hostel, but when I told him the story of getting food poisoned in Albania, he finally sympathized with me and let me hang out in the hostel and just recover before taking the bus to go to Bulgaria. The man who ran the Macedonian hostel told me that he used to live in the US, but he felt like the US was a good place to make money, but he felt like there was no soul while he was living in the US. So he took his savings, went back to Macedonia, started a hostel, and he said that he's been happy with that decision ever since. When it was time to leave Macedonia, I went to the bus station, and the bus station there was pretty chaotic. There was a lot of touts trying to sell you something, and it had a pretty unfriendly vibe from my perspective. Regardless, I managed to purchase some tickets and take the bus all the way to Bulgaria, and the bus ride was pretty smooth, and it was a lot better than the horrific bus ride that I took going from Montenegro to Albania, Kosovo, and finally in Macedonia. Anyways, that's my adventure in that part of the world. I can't say I would like to go back to any of these places, maybe in Montenegro because I would like to see Kotor, but otherwise that horrible experience has been etched in my memory, and just thinking about it makes me feel sick, no pun intended. Anyways, that's about it for this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave your comments below. And don't forget to sign up to the Travel and Live Free newsletter, where you can get a 10-step cheat sheet on how to travel around the world. You'll also get the latest tips and strategies on how to save money on travel for Canadians, how to go on an around-the-world adventure travel for Canadians, and how to use travel to get more freedom in your life as a Canadian. You can sign up for the newsletter in the description below. Until next time, I'll see you then.